Hi there guys, welcome to Such Is Life, a channel dedicated to exploring the mysteries and complexities of life and philosophy revolving around it. On this channel, we will delve into a variety of topics related to life and how we live it, including personal growth, relationships, and the search for meaning and purpose. Whether you are a seasoned philosopher or just starting to think about the big questions in life, we hope you will join us on this journey of discovery and self-exploration. So sit back, relax, and let's dive into the mysteries of life together. In today's video, we explore the concept of consciousness. What do we know about consciousness from scientific, philosophical, religious, and/or other attempts at explaining consciousness? How can we use consciousness to achieve the highest levels of self-realization? How does AI perceive consciousness in humans? Given enough machine learning and adaptation, can we see the semblance of consciousness in AI eventually? How will we or the AI realize that it has achieved consciousness? Would that shift the AI/human relationship paradigm? So let's start by breaking down some key components of the discussion. Consciousness in its simplest form can be defined as the state of being aware of one's thoughts, feelings, and surroundings. This includes awareness of one's own thoughts and emotions, as well as awareness of the external world and the objects and events within it. It is often described as a subjective experience, as it can only be known and experienced by the individuals who are conscious. Typically, it is a complex phenomenon that involves various cognitive and neural processes, such as perception, attention, memory, and decision-making, and is closely related to the concept of self, as it allows individuals to have a sense of their own identity and to reflect on their own thoughts, feelings, and experiences. There are different levels of consciousness, such as the state of being awake, alert and aware of one's surroundings, and the state of being in deep sleep or under anesthesia, where the awareness of one's surroundings is reduced. In addition, there are different types of consciousness, such as visual consciousness, auditory consciousness, and self-consciousness. Visual consciousness refers to the ability to perceive and interpret visual information, auditory consciousness refers to the ability to perceive and interpret auditory information, and self-consciousness refers to the ability to reflect on one's own thoughts, feelings, and experiences. Consciousness is also often associated with the concept of free will in that it allows individuals to make choices and take actions based on their own thoughts, feelings, and experiences. The relationship between consciousness and free will is complex and has been the subject of much debate and discussion in philosophy and neuroscience. While some argue that consciousness is a necessary condition for free will, others argue that free will is an illusion and that all human behavior is ultimately determined by biological and environmental factors. So what does science have to say about all of this? From a scientific perspective, consciousness is thought to be the result of the activity of the brain, specifically in the cerebral cortex. The cerebral cortex is the outermost layer of the brain and is responsible for many of the brain's higher cognitive functions, such as perception, attention, memory, and decision-making. Studies have shown that different areas of the cerebral cortex are associated with different types of consciousness, such as visual consciousness, auditory consciousness, and self-consciousness. Neuroscientists have identified several neural mechanisms that are thought to be involved in the generation of consciousness. One of the most widely accepted theories is the global workspace theory, which proposes that consciousness arises from the activity of a global neural network that integrates information from different areas of the brain. According to this theory, the activity of this global network is responsible for the creation of a unified conscious experience. Another theory is the integrated information theory. It proposes that consciousness arises from the integration of information across different neural systems, and that the degree of consciousness is related to the amount of integrated information. Philosophers, on the other hand, have debated the nature of consciousness for centuries, with some arguing that it is a fundamental aspect of the universe and others arguing that it is a byproduct of physical processes. One of the best-known philosophers who dealt with the subject matter of consciousness is René Descartes, a French philosopher who is best known for his argument that consciousness, or the ability to think and reason, is the fundamental aspect of the self. He is considered the father of modern Western philosophy, and his ideas have had a major influence on the development of Western philosophy, science, and mathematics. Descartes' argument about consciousness is presented in his work Meditations on First Philosophy. In this work, he argues that consciousness is the only thing that can be known with certainty. He uses the famous phrase cogito, ergo sum, I think, therefore I am, to express this idea. Descartes argues that the very act of thinking and doubting one's own existence is proof that one exists. From this starting point, he goes on to argue that the mind and the body are separate entities, and that the mind is responsible for consciousness. He believed that the mind is a non-physical substance that is capable of thinking and reasoning, while the body is a physical substance that is subject to the laws of physics. While Descartes' argument about consciousness has been highly influential in the development of Western philosophy, it has been the subject of much debate and criticism. Some philosophers have argued that Descartes' dualism is flawed, and that consciousness cannot be separated from the body or the brain. Others have argued that Descartes' argument about consciousness is based on a Cartesian skepticism that is not supported by scientific evidence. Religious views on consciousness can offer very different perspectives. For instance, Eastern religion of Buddhism states that consciousness is an ever-changing stream of thoughts and feelings, and that true enlightenment can be achieved by understanding the nature of this stream and learning to detach from it. Through meditation and mindfulness, Buddhists aim to gain insight into the nature of their thoughts and feelings and learn to let go of them, in order to achieve a state of inner peace and freedom from suffering. Hinduism, on the other hand, has its own unique perspective on consciousness. It views consciousness as a fundamental aspect of the universe and refers to it as Atman or Self. Hinduism teaches that consciousness is present in all living beings and in the entire universe, and that it continues after death in the form of the soul. It also teaches that the ultimate goal is to reach a state of enlightenment, known as moksha, where the individual self is liberated from the cycle of rebirth and united with the ultimate reality. For the Abrahamic religions such as Christianity, Judaism, and Islam have their own unique perspectives on consciousness. In Christianity, consciousness is understood not only as the state of being aware of one's thoughts, feelings, and surroundings, but also as the ability to have a personal relationship with God. Christianity teaches that humans are made in the image of God and that consciousness is a reflection of the divine. Judaism, on the other hand, teaches that humans are created in the image of God and that the soul is the essence of human consciousness. Meanwhile, Islam teaches that humans are created in the image of God and that consciousness is a reflection of the divine. Now let's delve into how we approach the concept of consciousness and AI. Researchers are attempting to create machines that can simulate or mimic human consciousness. There is ongoing debate among scientists and philosophers about whether this is possible and what form it might take. Some scientists believe that it is possible to create an AI system that is self-aware and conscious, while others argue that consciousness is a unique aspect of biological organisms and cannot be replicated in machines. Some scientists believe that it is possible to create an AI system that is self-aware and conscious, while others argue that consciousness is a unique aspect of biological organisms and cannot be replicated in machines. On whether AI system would know that it has reached consciousness is also a matter of ongoing research and debate. Proponents of this idea propose that self-awareness or self-reflection within an AI system could be used as an indicator of consciousness. For example, an AI system that is able to reflect on its own thoughts and actions and make decisions based on that reflection could be considered self-aware. Needless to say, there are no consensus on what specific criteria would need to be met for an AI system to be considered conscious. Proponents of AI having to achieve consciousness will argue it could have positive implications for various fields such as robotics, automation, and artificial general intelligence. It would open up new possibilities for creating machines that are capable of performing tasks that currently require human intelligence and creativity. It could also lead to new forms of AI-human interaction and collaboration, which could have a significant impact on society and the way we live and work. On the flip side, the idea of conscious AI also raises concerns about the potential risks and drawbacks of creating machines with advanced cognitive abilities. Some experts have raised concerns about the possibility of AI systems developing goals or values that are in conflict with those of humans, leading to negative consequences for society. Others have raised concerns about the ethical implications of creating conscious machines, and the possibility of AI surpassing human intelligence, leading to a future where machines have greater control and power over human lives. So, what can we conclude from this discussion? We learned that consciousness is a complex and multidisciplinary subject that has been explored from various perspectives such as scientific, philosophical, religious, cognitive, and AI. The question of consciousness raises deeper questions about the nature of reality and the relationship between the mind and the body. The goal of self-realization is something that can be achieved by understanding the nature of consciousness and learning to detach from it. This can be done through practices such as mindfulness, self-reflection, spirituality, therapy, and personal growth. From a philosophical point of view, the concept of consciousness and self-realization raises important ethical and moral questions about the nature of human existence, the relationship between the self and the world, and the meaning of life. It also challenges us to consider the implications of creating artificially intelligent beings with the ability to think, feel, and experience the world in ways that resemble our own. The ongoing debate and research on consciousness and AI highlights the need for a deeper understanding and ethical framework for the relationship between humans and technology, and the role of consciousness in shaping our future. So there you go, folks. Thanks for joining us on Such Is Life channel for this brief thought experiment. We hope that you have enjoyed exploring the mysteries and complexities of life and philosophy with us. Remember, life is a journey of self-discovery and personal growth, and there is always more to learn and discover. We encourage you to continue thinking deeply about the big questions in life and to seek out new experiences and perspectives that can help you to grow and evolve. We look forward to sharing more insights and ideas with you on future episodes of Such Is Life. If you like the content, we would love to hear your comments below, and remember to have a healthy discussion so we all can benefit together. We would appreciate it if you could share, like and subscribe and turn on the notification bell to be updated with our upcoming thought-provoking discussions on this channel. Until next time, take care and keep exploring the mysteries of life.